The Universal Declaration of Human Rights was adopted in the night of December the 10th, 1948. Eleanor Roosevelt referred to it as the Magna Carta of mankind. They asked me to prepare a draft of a declaration on human rights.
I'm often asked how I became a human rights defender. And for me, the response is easy, because I myself suffered of racial discrimination. And so there was a year when my employer at that time just stopped calling me to work with him. And I was really surprised because I thought that we were in good terms and I did a good job. So when I asked him and the company why I don't get assigned anymore to any of the tasks, I was told into my eyes that because the boss figured out that you are Roma, you are a gypsy girl, and that's too shameful for the company. And I was fired. But from that moment, it was clear that I have to be a human rights defender working against discrimination and for the protection of minorities. I came across Equitas 15 years ago. In 2003, I had the enormous privilege to travel to Montreal and be part of the human rights training program. It was a life-changing experience.
J'ai participé à la création du livret 100% Elle. Ça parle de plusieurs enjeux auxquels les filles doivent faire face, dont le viol, les relations amoureuses, la dépression et tout ça. Tout d'abord, ça vous permet d'informer. Donc, les filles qui ne sont pas au courant, donc ça leur informe. Puis ça leur dit, par exemple, si tu as une relation toxique, voici les signes et tout ça. C'est important pour moi parce que puisque moi, j'ai la chance d'acquérir des connaissances puis de me renseigner sur des sujets comme ça, je trouve que c'est aussi important de partager ces informations-là avec d'autres jeunes qui n'ont pas la chance que moi j'ai.
The catalyst that brought all this about and was really one of the causes of the war was, of course, the gross violations of human rights that occurred during that war and immediately before it. And this shocked the conscience of mankind. It also produced a certain idealism. You know, there's a very close connection between respect for human rights and peace.
I do want to connect with other human rights defenders because with this common voice and common strategies for advocacy, we are indeed much more stronger than alone.
J'ai tendance à être un leader dans tout l'espoir de ma vie, puis ça c'est grâce à Equitas. Il y a plusieurs enjeux. Par exemple, il y a de la discrimination raciale, il y a beaucoup de violences faites aux femmes. Et je pense que le plus grand danger, c'est le fait que les gens ne s'en rendent pas compte. Je voudrais vivre dans une communauté plus tolérante, plus qui accepte les personnes sans, comme ils sont, sans discrimination raciale, sans discrimination religieuse ou discrimination basée sur le sexe.
Please step up your game and be more active than you are today in fighting hatred, bigotry, and discrimination around you.
Quand tu remarques qu'il y a quelque chose qui ne va pas, il faut le dénoncer. Il ne faut pas tolérer ce qui ne doit pas être toléré.
If you open the social media and you see a video of hate speech, please don't close your laptop or your phone, but take a moment to put a comment down. If somebody else visits the same page, your opinion will be there. So those who think likewise, those who want love and peace and friendship prevail, will see that they are not alone, but there are other people who think the same way, who refuse hate speech.
It doesn't have to be something big, it could be something small. So if you see somebody that needs to be defended, defend them. If you see something that's not right, say it, and don't tolerate what does not deserve to be tolerated. So, and if you just do that, and it'll probably give others the courage to speak up as well. And if we all start speaking up, then we could make a bigger change. So it all starts with something small, and it can lead to something bigger.
We stand today at the threshold of a great event, both in the life of the United Nations and in the life of mankind. This Universal Declaration of Human Rights may well become the international Magna Carta of all men everywhere.
Je pense que c'est important de mobiliser les jeunes à défendre leurs droits parce que le futur nous appartient, donc il suffit de prendre ce qui est à nous.